Very emotional episode last night. Three became two on The Bachelor Australia as last night we saw Matt send Helena home.
I think we have a great connection, but I have absolutely no idea what Matt's thinking. I'm just trying to remain level-headed. I'm just trying to stay real about it.
Chelsea. Saying goodbye to Helena was the right thing. I want someone who is certain they want me, as I am, and someone who is willing to work for a relationship and not run away when things get tough.
Wow.
And Helena joins us now in the studio. Oh.
Does that guy actually play the piano when they...
In the rose ceremony room?
Yeah.
No.
I love that bit.
Helena, how are you feeling watching that?
It actually never gets easier. Like, I obviously watched it last night, but now watching it again, it's like... Yeah, it's really emotional. Even last night, I thought I was going to be okay because obviously it's been a couple of months since it all happened. But I honestly just burst into tears and I was like... Yeah.
Now, we've got to unpack the home visit.
Yes.
Because obviously that impacted on everything.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
You walked out not once but twice. What was really going on in your mind there? What was happening?
So there's a little bit more to it than is shown. I'm never one to walk away from just one thing.
Sure.
You know, otherwise I would never be in a relationship.
Yeah.
But there were a couple of things that he forgot. You know, how we met. He asked if I was like a theatre nurse, which is like the furthest thing from my occupation, and then he asked where I was from, and it just kind of had made the basis of so many of our dates and our conversations. And when he forgot all those things in a row, I just kind of thought to myself, like, am I the one? Especially because he was good at remembering so many different things about every single girl.
So did you say that to him? Did you say that to him?
I said that to him, absolutely. Like, I'm not one to hide my feelings, and I was so... My heart, like, I just went cold. My blood went cold.
And what did he say when he realised he'd got
things
wrong?
He was like, all he did was really apologise. And then I think one or two things he, like, said, no, I didn't say that. And I was like, well, you did, because we were at the dinner table with my family. Like, we all heard it. And it's fine. Like, I understand it's like a pressure cooker of a situation, but when there's those kind of things in a row and it's coming to the end of it, I kind of thought... Okay, I don't think I'm the one.
But then you went back.
Then I went back. He came back for me twice, so I was like, maybe I'm overreacting and I'm thinking too much into it and maybe I need to give him another chance.
You spoke about the fact that he forgot certain details, like when you met, and then last night he remembered specific details about Chelsea. How did you... I've watched this very intently.
Yeah.
How did you feel watching that, thinking, hang on a minute, you remembered everything about Chelsea and then gave her a special little nerdy gift?
Yeah, he literally, like, play-by-play of their, like, meeting on the red carpet. I think when I watched that, I was like, OK. You know, I think that really just hammered it home for me.
So he's just not that into you.
That's exactly it, which is so fine.
Yeah,
well, it's fine.
He
but
would
it's...
constantly asking you to sort of open up more. I mean, if there anything you would have done differently in hindsight, because hindsight is such a wonderful thing.
Oh, it is a wonderful thing. Probably not, actually. I think I stayed true to myself. I think what I felt was real. And I don't think I would take anything back.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you were watching last night. We've discussed Chelsea. What did you make of Abby?
It was a bit rooty-moody, wasn't it?
Raunchy, wasn't that time slot?
Yeah, I was kind of, like, looking through my fingers, but...
Did that surprise you?
No.
No?
I mean, every single one of their dates has been, like, the raunchiest thing ever, but I couldn't do that knowing that there's six cameras on me and that my family eventually is going to be watching.
I think we might... I was worried about the waves coming up and... when they were on the beach.
I don't think that would have deterred them. I think underwater it still would have kept going.
There's a lot of chemistry there.
So they were really getting it on.
Okay.
So on that point, on who's going to win, do you think Matt's going to go for the nerdy connection or do you think he's going to go for the sexual chemistry?
I have no idea.
Really?
Like, I'm genuinely torn. I think I'm with the rest of the nation on this when I have no idea what he's going to go
with. So you can't go... You cannot pick one?
I think his his scientific side's going to take over, and I think he's literally going to weigh up the pros and cons.
His
and
head over his.
Over.
Do you think he's? Yeah,
that, I want to hear that. Like that showing
the, over the other.
The male head. The male
head.
Yeah. Oh, hello.
It was, and I was worried about them on the beach, not watching the waves, water safety.
So you,
lifeguard, also.
Do you actually think his brain is going to take over?
I think in the end it will.
Yeah. Yep. My tip is Chelsea will win.
Mm-hmm. Because Abby's had a bit of a bad rap, hasn't she?
She hasn't had the best rap. I mean, like, everyone is kind
of... Is she nice or is she a bit of a cow?
And No, I wouldn't say Abby was a cow. She's very... She's very out there. She's very open with her sexuality. She has.
Forward.
She's not apologetic for anything that she does. And maybe we can actually take a leaf out of her book.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you found love?
I haven't.
Mm. All right.
No,
so...
I think you have now, darling.
Oh, stop it.
Or, if not Jono, perhaps Bachi in Paradise.
Yes.
Never say never, but I think it's something I'd really have to sit down and think about. It scares me a little bit, the thought of going on.
We have loved watching you, though.
Thank
Eleanor,
you.
Eleanor, you were fantastic.
Thank
and thank you,
you
very much for joining us
thanks,
this morning
guys.
On Studio
thank
10.
You.
And make sure you tune in to the Bachelor finale tonight at 7:30 on 10.
I'd like
and
to apologise to my current wife. That was just television fun.
Your first wife.
Yeah.
Your first wife.